Joining us now to discuss, Andrea Dutton. She's Associate Professor of Geology at the University of Florida. We should mention that Andrea's research was cited in the Trump administration's climate report. So this is now a full court press from this administration, because you heard the same from Sarah Sanders at the White House podium saying, well, this was not based on facts, this assessment. Basically saying that you can't do modeling, I imagine, right? She's saying you can't look into the future based on the data you know now. You're an expert here. Explain how you do that and why the White House position here is misplaced.
Okay, so I'm actually a geologist, and I study the past climate and sea level change. So I'm a little bit like a CSI of planet Earth, a crime scene investigator. And it turns out that when we look for what the evidence is of what has been causing this warming, we see the fingerprints of carbon dioxide all over the place. So carbon dioxide is basically like the world's dumbest criminal, because everywhere we look, we can see evidence for this. And when we run our models, we know that other things affect climate change. And when we put all those other factors in, we can't reproduce that warming trend that we see in the record. The only way we can reproduce that warming trend is by adding in the greenhouse gas emissions that we've been producing. So when they say it's not based on fact, we have a mountain of scientific literature showing us that data. Our models confirm it as well. And then we hear they don't want to believe it. When they say they don't believe it, I wonder if they're saying they don't want to believe it, because I don't want to believe it either, to be honest. Right. I mean, we could totally agree on that point, because that means I have to buy into the scary parts of the story, too.
Sure. Mm-hmm. That are very near, right? Near-term scary things that are predicted that could happen as a result. The president tweeted just about a week ago, quote, "Whatever happened to global warming," right, on a cold, snowy day. Can you explain to everyone why this is not, climate change is not about the weather of a day or a week?
Absolutely. I actually go into the elementary schools around me and I teach this to kids at a young age, that there's a difference between climate and weather. So when we talk about climate, we're talking about a long-term trend, like 30 years or more. We're not talking about day-to-day weather or 1 year. So you can't infer what's happening with climate change just by looking at the weather on a single day, or even within a single year, right? We have to be looking at that long-term trend that is amplifying some of the extreme weather effects that we see.
I mean, the president also either deliberately or mistakenly messes up the distinction between a clean environment and a warming environment. He keeps saying, well, we have record clean environment, doesn't get to the temperature issue. But I just want to ask you a question for folks at home, folks like us. We got kids. We don't want to be, you know, slowly burned to death on our own planet here. I mean, is the human race, in the simplest terms, running out of time to take the measures necessary to rein in this rise in global temperatures?
Right. So this issue is becoming more and more urgent by the passing day and the passing year, based on the amount of emissions that we are still producing. And our administration is leading us in that direction of producing more emissions by supporting coal instead of turning to clean energy. And so we're running out of time in terms of avoiding the most dangerous effects. But anything that we can do, and the more that we can do, the sooner the better. The sooner we fix it, the better the outcome to avoid the most dangerous effects of this.
Well said.
We can only hope. Dr. Andrea Dutton, thanks very much.